What's going on, everybody? This is the AMR Podcast in Review, and we just got done watching Resident Evil Apocalypse. And, you know, if you guys want to know the story, the story is almost essentially the same as Resident Evil 2/3, where basically Raccoon City has been infested with the T-virus, or, say, G-virus, and, you know, it's just basically a story about people trying to escape the city. Now, granted, it's the movie, so it's the T-virus, people trying to escape the city while also trying to save a little girl while also trying to avoid the nemesis.
But, like, the nemesis doesn't care about, like, the regular people in the city. He just wants to kill stars, which I understand, but I would think the real nemesis would just kill anything in its way.
I think in the games he does. But honestly, in this movie, they treated his whole killing stars like an afterthought. Because he had one scene where he killed like maybe 20 stars members.
Yeah.
And that was it. That was the only stars killing scene. He doesn't even give a shit about Jill Valentine's existence.
No. But he cared a little bit about Alice's existence.
Yeah. So, let's get into this. So, honestly, listening to your reactions during this movie was pretty hilarious. What did you think of this movie?
I don't know. Like, it was, like I said, it's, like, bad. It's, like, Sharknado bad. But Sharknado doesn't take itself seriously, and these movies do. So if they didn't take themselves seriously, it probably would have been more entertaining.
It probably would be. I think they finally don't give a shit after when the fourth movie comes out.
Okay.
Because the third movie still, in my opinion, still feels serious, but the fourth movie is just plain old stupid action.
Okay.
I mean, the fourth movie, they introduced the Las Plagas.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just stupid action right after that.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, so you think it's pretty much a bad movie, but, like, that bad type that you can enjoy a little bit.
Yeah.
What did you think? You had a bit of a thing about Alice.
I just feel like she wasn't, like, necessary. And also, like, in the first movie, she was, like, really weak and pathetic. And then they inject her with the virus, and all of a sudden she's Wonder Woman. Like, wouldn't there be some, like, downtime where she has to, like, get used to having the virus in her before she went all superhuman?
You know, that makes more sense. Like, why on earth? She's all shaky when she gets her clothes, and you see, like, something in her system, and then next time you see her, she's all badass.
Right.
You would think, like, she would need time. Like, that's not something you get used to right away. You need, like, maybe an hour.
She wanted Marvin to die immediately. She somehow was able to kill all of the Lickers in the church.
In a very Leon S. Kennedy way.
Mm-hmm. Where'd she get the motorcycle?
Oh, that I have no idea.
She just had a motorcycle.
She probably just stole it off the street. And then don't get me started on Jill. Jill Valentine is easily one of my favorite Resident Evil characters. I think they did a great job with her. I'm not gonna lie, I think they did a good job.
With who, like, how she looks and everything? Yeah, but first of all, Jill promotes smoking. That's no good in 2020. I don't know what date this movie came out, but she just kind of looks like a jackass.
I'm not going to lie. This did not come out in 2020.
Well, I know, but she just looks stupid. And then, second of all, every time there was a major action scene, Jill, before the big, like, finale of the action scene, Jill just stops, and then Alice takes over. So Jill does all of the hard work, and then Alice gets the big finale.
Yeah, and either that or Alice gets the big finish.
That's like, what I mean.
No, I mean, like, in the school. Like, when Jill had the big plan.
And well, that's what I mean. Like, Jill does, like, everything, and then at the end, Alice swoops in and finishes whatever they're doing.
Well, that's because you gotta make your wife seem like the hero.
Well, I don't care, because I don't really understand her purpose of being in these movies. And I really didn't understand. Like, I was so happy when they reunited the daughter and the dad. I was like, oh, okay. He created the virus, but, like, at least they're together now. And then for some reason, when I don't even know who that main Umbrella guy was.
I don't know who he's supposed to be based off of.
I don't know, but you know, he really wants Alice to fight Nemesis at the end of the movie, and he's like, oh, you want these people to die? And she's like, I don't care. Like, just saying that, just because she can. And then he turns around, and instead of shooting one of the people that she has been with this whole movie, he turns around and shoots the dad. And I don't really understand that. And I don't understand why they even fought at the end of the movie.
And then Nemesis is all buddy-buddy.
Well, I get that because they knew each other.
I think Nemesis...
they, like, made that connection with each other.
Yeah, but Nemesis went out like a bitch.
Nemesis was not important. Nemesis was there for fan service only.
Oh, yeah. And the fact that, you know, I want to see some Birkin. You know, that's what I'm hoping for when they do this Netflix Resident Evil series, is they follow closer to the games.
I don't know. As long as Alice isn't in it.
I hope not, because apparently it's supposed to follow Alice's children or something.
What?
Yeah, I don't know. I'm hoping it's a reboot.
What? I don't understand. These movies are not good. They're not good. Why are there six of them? And why are they making a Netflix series out of movies that are known to be bad?
Oh no, it's not confirmed that it is. It's a theory or a rumor. So it's not confirmed yet. There is a Netflix series being made, but no one knows officially what it's about.
I would rather it just be like a documentary on how the games were made at this point.
Damn.
Now, you said the next one, Wesker, is in it?
Yep.
So I kind of want to see that.
Why do I feel like, from that tone of voice, though, like, after finishing this one, you're like, I don't know if I want to keep watching.
No, I am. I'm watching this whole series because I need to understand why they made six of them. Why? And they keep ending the movies like they know that, oh yeah, this is going to do well. We're going to make another one.
But you thought the action pieces were better than the first one and because the CGI. Well,
you know what? The first one didn't really have any action.
Mm-hmm. And also, Paul W. Sanderson doesn't know how to film action.
I don't know what he knows how to do.
He's honestly just as bad as
Chris. Has he played the games?
I think he said he played a little bit, or he just saw the cover.
I don't really understand.
But, like, he doesn't know how to do action scenes just as much as Christopher Nolan. Like, I'm not going to lie, Christopher Nolan really sucks at action scenes. And they're basically the same way that action scenes are filmed in this movie and in the last movie.
So, the third one still has Jill in it?
No.
Where does she go?
No one knows.
She's just kind of disappeared.
She's not dead. That I will tell you, she's not dead. She does come back.
Okay. So, who is in the third one? Just Wesker?
Claire, Carlos, and Wesker.
That's a weird combination.
Yep. And then Resident Evil 4 is Claire, Chris, and Wesker.
Mm-hmm.
Retribution, Ada, Jill, Barry, Leon. And then Resident Evil Final Chapter, Wesker.
I have to wait three other movies to see Leon?
Yeah. The one that looks like a porn star.
This is going to be difficult. But I am going to do this. We're going to watch them all. We have nothing else to do. We're in Corona quarantine.
But the question though, if you had to say which one was better, this one or the last movie?
Probably still the last one.
Because of Alice?
Because the first one just makes more sense. It's just more coherent. Like, I really didn't have any questions about the first one. This one, I felt like I needed to question a lot towards the end. Like, why is this happening?
Yeah, I can understand that. Oh, and also Jill doesn't smoke in the game, so I don't know why the fuck they added that.
Like I said, this is the early 2000s. They probably saw that as like a way to look like badass or something.
Basically. But we're going to end the review on this. Personally for me, I think this definitely went down on the table for me. I don't remember it being as bad as it was. I remember being bad, but I don't remember being that bad. It's definitely not the worst one. I still hate Retribution. I'm going to laugh if that actually, if I watch it and it changes my mind. But yeah. First one is still my favorite. So with that being said, thank you guys for listening, and we will see you again next time.
Bye.